The genesis of this framework stemmed from the third commemoration of the Geneva Consensus Declaration, a testament to global collaboration in prioritizing women's health. Designed by the Institute for Women's Health, the framework champions a holistic approach to women's well-being, tailored to respect Uganda's cultural, religious, and societal values. In her address, the First Lady of Uganda and Minister for Education and Sports, Janet Kataha Museveni, expressed concern regarding the state of women's education on health matters. She underscored the critical need to address this gap, emphasizing that women's health encompasses a spectrum of challenges unique to each life stage, from mental health to reproductive well-being, from balanced nutrition to stress management.
I want to welcome and thank once again all our guests, especially the Institute of Women's Health, really for deciding to bring this launch to Uganda, when Uganda is being intimidated by so many people. This institute leadership have decided to come and stand with us openly, transparently, and show that they want to do this in Uganda and hold hands with Ugandans because they believe we are doing something right.
Valerie Huber, the president of the Institute for Women's Health and Architecture of the framework, emphasized the necessity for comprehensive approach to women's health that respects cultural nuances and societal contexts.
Only confuse, complicate, and often derail reprogress. Today's launch of the Women's Optimal Health Framework is evidence of our priority. Uganda's the natural location for this launch. As regional leader of the Geneva Consensus, yes. As regional leader of the Geneva Consensus Declaration, or GCD, you represent Africa in a historic and first of its kind coalition. And it, as I said before, provides the fertile ground for real women's health to grow and thrive throughout the entire continent of Africa. Thank you.
Zita Oluiji Nwema, the First Lady of Gabon, underscored the importance of improving access to public health services for women, recognizing it as a cornerstone of societal progress.
I welcome you all to this meeting, which I see as a great opportunity to discuss the ways and means of promoting low-cost, high-impact actions for women's health.
Mesdames et messieurs,
ladies and gentlemen,
la contribution des femmes est primordiale au développement économique de nos pays.
Women's play a central in economic development of our countries.
Car elles disposent d'un immense potentiel réduit par de nombreux obstacles qui les empêchent d'être pleinement impliquées et d'avoir un impact optimal sur le développement du continent.
However, they are faced with great challenges that impede them from contributing their great potential to the development of our continent.
L'un des obstacles majeurs demeure la difficile réponse aux problèmes de santé.
One of the major obstacles remains the inadequate response to women's health.
Report by Sharon Navasini for the news.